My name is Lazulek Thom, and I am the founder of a company called Beijing Postcards. And what we do is that we collect the memory of Beijing. We collect maps and photos, and we interview old Beijing people, and we are making exhibitions and products and all kinds of historically related projects. I've been in Beijing for 16 years and 4 years in Kunming, so altogether 20 years in China. The initial idea is to make people relate to the city of Beijing. Because that the development is so fast, or has been so fast, then I think even to Chinese people living in Beijing, then it can be difficult to catch up with Beijing and sort of understand how did Beijing become the city it is today. So we hope that people can come here and use the place as a platform to gain a simple understanding of, a general understanding of how did Beijing become the city it is today. We started to understand that Beijing 100 years ago, 50 years ago, was a very different place compared with what we actually thought of, maybe instinctively thought that it was like. So we started to sort of dive into the history and realize that there was a whole lot of stories that were not told. I have a map that we have collected that was made by the Germans. When you look at that map, then you can see that outside of the city gates, then you have a lot of settlement. But if you look at most maps of Beijing from like 100, 200, 300 years ago, then those settlements, they're not in the maps. And why is that? That is because it was sort of the floating population. But in this German map, that is a military map, you mapped everything because you didn't care about appearance. You cared about what was actually there. So I think it's a very honest portrait of Beijing 120 years ago. We are very interested in the Forbidden City. Like every week we have we go into the Forbidden City. And I think that understanding the Forbidden City in depth is definitely something that is a big focus of ours. One thing that often happens when you have studied a lot is that you think that you know. But that is often the biggest mistake you can ever make, because nobody knows entirely. And somebody that doesn't have a relation to the Forbidden City can actually ask super interesting questions that will make you understand that you actually have a whole lot of blank spots. And the Forbidden City, in my view, is so important to the concept of being Chinese, to the concept of management in China and government. And it is such a treasure. It's like there's so much to learn about it.